Alright, welcome back to the channel. Max Torno here. We're still in Cyprus, enjoying this beautiful evening. Sun has just gone down. And in this video, I want to talk about how nobody actually needs you to be perfect. You're probably following this channel and following my journey and whatever it is that you want to be doing in your life. A big reason why you haven't started it yet is because you think you need to be perfect, because you think you need to be good enough for that. And I can keep telling you that that's not true, and you kind of understand it on a surface level. But a great way for you to really internalize it is if I tell a little bit of a story about my own career. More specifically, I want to tell you the two biggest mistakes in my career so far. And bear in mind, I've built multiple seven-figure businesses in my life. I've been touring the world four times and so on and so forth. So this has a little bit of gravity to your situation, hopefully. So my very first big mistake was in the beginning of my career. I had just started being an online coach, but I was by no means very successful at it yet. Because I thought I needed to be perfect in order to be successful. I thought I needed to be perfect in order to have other people be willing to listen to me. So what I did was, first off, I tried to become really, really perfect. And then once I thought I was kind of good, I started to hide my shortcomings. I tried to just never ever show them and always just make sure that I'm as perfect as possible, right? When I shot videos, I used to shoot videos 6-7 times. My very, very first couple of videos, there was like 6-7 versions of it. Sometimes I would even freak out when I just published a video on YouTube. I'm like, oh my God, it's not perfect enough. I have to take it down. What happened was my breakthrough moment in my very first business, the dating advice and relationship advice business. The breakthrough moment was where I stopped trying to be perfect, where I stopped trying to pursue this false perfection, and I started becoming more vulnerable. I started talking about my shortcomings. I started, you know, showing imperfect things on my YouTube channel and on my social media. What happened, all of a sudden, people started resonating. People didn't resonate with me when I tried to be perfect and to act like I'm the total pro. People started resonating with me as I started becoming more vulnerable, as I started being more transparent, more real. Because what you have to understand, a little bit of a marketing lesson here, people don't buy authority, a little bit, but not ultimately. People don't buy perfection. People don't necessarily buy the knowledge. People buy the person. People buy from someone they can resonate with. People buy from someone that seems to be honest and transparent. And even if you are perfect, even if you truly really are, it will seem too good to be true for these people, and they'll still buy from someone else that they can resonate with more. So I hope that can already kind of show you the lesson that nobody needs you to be perfect. You think everybody needs you to be perfect, but it's not true. Which brings me to my second biggest mistake of my career. That was way later down the line, where I was so good, I was so successful, I was making so much money, I thought I was perfect. What happened was people stopped resonating. They started resonating years before when I showed my imperfections. They stopped resonating when I seemed to be too arrogant, when I seemed to be too perfect. What I started having to do was get a little bit of real outside perspective in, understand that I'm not indeed perfect, and that it's actually totally fine, even after all these years, even after all these millions, to still show my flaws, to still be open about it, to still be real. What happened was people started resonating again. So the lesson for you here is, if you try to pursue perfection, not only are you procrastinating because you're never going to be perfect, but also what you'll do is you'll push people away. And even if you do want to build your very first business, if you try to go for perfection, people will see some dissonance in that. They'll see a disconnect, and they will see it as a reason to not become your client, to not buy from you, to not watch your stuff. So ultimately, you chasing perfection is the worst thing you could ever do. Instead, chase being real. Chase honesty, chase transparency. And what will happen is the following, and we'll get to this in a second. If you haven't done so yet, go follow me on my Instagram account. I'm trying to be as real as humanly possible on my Instagram account, and I believe it's a relatively good example of kind of seeing, like, this is where you have to be professional and this is where you can be real, and really finding that balance. So if you haven't done so yet, you probably have my your phone in your hand anyway, so go ahead and give a follow. I also reply to DMs, so feel free to hit me up. Anyways, That perfectionism is wrong, and it keeps you from taking action. But most importantly, trying to hold up a false, perfect picture of yourself, what that actually does to you is it costs you a lot of energy. And I always like thinking back to these times where I tried to uphold this fake perfect persona of myself. It kept costing me so much goddamn energy because, well, I had to hold up this false mask over myself. And that's exactly what happens for you if you try to be perfect. It costs you energy. Whereas instead, if you just let go and you're just natural, you're just the way you're supposed to be. The way you're feeling, the way you're thinking, the way you're behaving. Then it doesn't cost you any energy. Then you can actually work harder. Then you can actually devote your time and energy into actually helping the people you do want to help. And actually building the thing you want to do. So trying to not be perfect or trying to go for authenticity. Well, I just noticed we have the light on here. That's actually amazing. So trying to go for authenticity actually costs you less and it has a much better effect on you. And it won't let you procrastinate. So to summarize, don't try to be perfect. Nobody needs you to be perfect. Be the way you are. Work hard. Go for your goals. And don't think you need to be perfect to be going for these goals. You never have to. All right? Thank you very much for watching. And if you're currently in a situation where you want to build your own freedom business, you want to feel free, you want to do something, you want to build something, but you don't know how, you feel confused, you don't know what the steps are, then go ahead and book a free consultation call with us. There's a link down in the description below. It brings you to a page. You can read through the page. There's more information for you on there. And at the bottom of that page, there's a link. There's a button. You click that. You fill out the application. Then you can book the exact in time with us to call you. Do you need to be perfect for doing that? No. Do you need to wait until the time is just perfectly right? No. Time is never going to be perfect. You're never going to be perfect. Might as well do that step now. So thank you very much for watching and talk to you soon.
Hello, my name is Do and I do fitness coaching, and before I joined FBM I've always kind of struggled with my business, and now that I'm not finished even with the program and I've already closed one client for 1.4k, and that's because I now understand much better what the people I'm trying to sell to actually want. It can really change your life.